कैफे नोमैड्स, कैफे नोमैड्स। जैसा कि हूँ मैं अभी ओरछा में और मैं यहाँ घूम रहा था, फिर मैं मिला उदेश भाई से जो कि है बिहार सिवान से। हाँ, तो अब बताइए जरा अपने बारे में, आप कैसे आए यहाँ पे?
मैं यहाँ पे आया बेसिकली मैं नौकरी में था। हाँ, गांव में बैंकिंग में।
अच्छा।
और वो मैंने 19 अप्रैल में छोड़ी।
अच्छा।
फिर उसके बाद मैं जगह ढूंढ रहा था कि कहाँ पे मैं शुरू कर सकता हूँ।
हाँ।
तो उसके लिए कुछ जगह मेरी सेट थी पहले से, बट वहाँ पे जब मैं वो जगह मैं घूमने में ढूंढ रखा था, बट वहाँ गया तो वो जगह फिर सेट नहीं हुई। तो ये जगह मेरे भाई ने मेरे को सजेस्ट
किया। ओरछा में? अच्छा, मैं ओरछा कब आया?
ओरछा मैं 19 जुलाई में आया था।
2019 में?
19।
अच्छा।
और मेरा भाई यहाँ पे पिछले 8 साल से हर साल आ रहा है, तो उसने सजेस्ट किया हुआ था कि जाके देखो।
अच्छा अच्छा।
मैं इधर आया, बहुत सही जगह लगी मेरे को, छोटी सी जगह है, पीसफुल है, ऑलमोस्ट सब कुछ ही है यहाँ पे। जंगल है, रिवर है, रिलीजन है, काफी स्ट्रॉन्ग आर्किटेक्चर है, हिस्ट्री है, जो भी एक जगह में आप ढूंढ सकते हो वो सब कुछ है।
सब कुछ है यहाँ पे ना?
सब कुछ ही है।
सही बात है।
और पॉपुलेशन बहुत कम है। इनफैक्ट इतने छोटे से शहर में मैं नॉर्थ इंडिया में कोई ऐसा जगह नहीं देखा जहाँ पे इतने छोटे से शहर में इतनी सारी चीजें आपको मिले जो नहीं मिलती है।
सही बात है।
वो सब मैं देखा। और प्लस यहाँ पे कैफे नहीं दिखा मुझे।
हाँ।
कोई भी प्रॉपर कैफे, कोई कैफे ट्रैवलर्स के लिए कैफे नहीं दिखा, और मेरा प्लान कैफे का था।
हाँ।
तो फिर सितंबर एंड तक तो मैंने कैफे शुरू कर लिया था फिर यहाँ
पर। एक बात है कि यहाँ पे मैंने भी अभी तक कोई भी टूरिस्ट कैफे जो है नहीं देखा है। एकमात्र कैफे है यहाँ पे। मैं भी 2016 में पहली बार आया था, जब उस समय यहाँ का पॉपुलेशन और भी कम था, और अब तो 2021 आ गया है और आप आए यहाँ पे 2019 में, तो आपको इतना अच्छा लगा कि आप यहीं रह गए।
यही रहेगा। हाँ। और प्लान भी यही है।
हाँ, यही रहना है, यही रहना हमेशा। अरे वाह।
देखते हैं, क्योंकि छोटे शहरों का एक अलग चार्म है।
चार्म होता है।
प्लस है, छोटा सा है, जो जिसके पास इतना कुछ ऑफर करने का है ये ढूंढना ही मुश्किल होता है।
सही बात है, ये तो बात है।
तो वो एक चार्म है मेरे पास, और मुझे वैसे भी भीड़ से दूर रहने का।
हाँ, ये बात आपने सही बोला कि यहाँ पे नेचर है, धर्म है,
सब कुछ ही है,
सब कुछ है।
हिस्ट्री
है,
इंडियन हिस्ट्री भी देखेंगे तो राजपूताना का भी इन्फ्लुएंस मिलेगा, मुगल्स का भी मिलेगा, और राम जी का इन्फ्लुएंस जो है वो तो है ही है। तो मतलब 2000 पुराने साल से लेके, 2000 साल से लेके और अभी रिसेंटली तक, मतलब 19th century तक की सब कुछ ही आपको मिलेगा यहाँ पे। प्लस रिवर यहाँ की अमेजिंग है।
हाँ, जो यह नदी है बेतवा नदी,
बहुत ही
ये जबरदस्त है ना। ये है इनकी वाइफ। ये पास बहुत स्पेस भी है, यहाँ बैठ के आप खा सकते हैं। रोड यहीं है। Sweet of the day. What do you have sweet of the day?
Yeah, we just got new one.
New one?
Yeah.
What is that?
Nomad's Bites.
Huh?
Nomad's Bites.
Nomad's Bite. Oh.
Yeah. So it's like sugar-free.
Sugar-free. That's good. Yeah. So this is the menu for today? Or
it's
for...
just some addition to the old menu which we got from this year.
We have new additions. Buddha Ball, Falafel Roll, veg biryani sandwich, cheese finger, lot of things. Drink of the day, tarhun passion. Is it made up of passion fruit?
No, it's made of tarhun.
Tarhun, what is tarhun?
Tarhun is like one kind of herb. We use it in Russia. So it's like very fragrant kind of.
So how did you get this thing in India?
It's available in India, you can like find it, but tarhun, it's not used. It's called tarragon.
Tarragon. Oh, I've never heard of this. Maybe
so
I know in Hindi.
I think in Mediterranean also. Yeah.
Okay.
But as a drink, we use it in Russia, like.
That's cool. That's cool.
Yeah.
Sweet of the day. Wow. So, do you like managing this?
I'm not basically managing it. I'm just like
enjoying the time being here.
Because I have to write my dissertation, so basically I do this. I come sometimes and
like Udesh said that he is so fond of this place that he wants to like spend all his life here.
Yeah, it's very nice.
But what do you think about that, his plan?
I also like this place.
So are you also willing to spend your life here?
Yeah, it's possible. It's very nice location. Like it takes only like few hours to Delhi. Like from Delhi you can go to Himachal and like northern India, then you can go to southern India, like east, west, like everywhere. You're in the middle of India, so it's nice.
Right. Quite in the middle.
Yeah.
So how do you find any difference in your lifestyle from Russia to here?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, like, how to say, in Russia, I am already like fully knowing like where get what, how to deal with things. Here, sometimes like I do not know like where to get this thing, for example, or how like to.
Yeah, because it's not familiar to you.
Yeah. But like I'm staying here for quite long, so like I'm already like.
And local.
Yeah, and I got him to ask like, okay, how to do this, to do this.
And I see that you're following a lot of Indian traditions, like you have sindoor. And then you have Mangal Sutra. So
yeah, I normally wear like everything. Today I'm just wearing like Eastern dress. I'm wearing Western, so I don't have the full pack. But yeah, normally I love to wear.
Is it because he told you to get this, or you just like it and
no,
then you do
no,
it?
No, I just like it.
You just like it.
Yeah, it's my personal choice. No one ever forced me.
But it looks quite pretty on you.
Yeah.
And you look pretty with all the Indian traditions.
Yeah,
it's cool.
I sometimes envy Indian girls, like the way they look in traditional outfit and how beautiful they are. So
how you got like, do you remember when the first time you got so interested in Indian tradition?
That was long ago, I think when I was a kid, like 11 years old, I guess. So like, I don't know, I actually do not know like when exactly I got attracted to that. But like most of the time I remember myself, I was in love with India.
Did you visit India when you were a child?
No.
Never?
Yeah.
What age did you come to India first time?
First time, I think 28.
28?
Yeah.
Oh.
When I got my first job, I got the money to come here, and like the first holiday I came here, and then I started to come regularly, and then I moved here.
And what place did you go first time?
I was in Delhi. In then I went to Himachal. In Himachal there is nice place called Nagar. There one Russian family used to live like one century ago. Like Nicholas Rorich, the famous artist. I'm a big fan of this family, so the first place where I went was Nagar. I went also to Punjab, stayed there, like went to the border in like Golden Temple. I think that's all like for first time I went like only like northern parts. Second time I went towards Varanasi and again to Himachal because I loved it a lot.
But usually in traditional way Goa is like more famous among Russians, but you didn't go to those areas, instead you went to northern part.
Yeah, I think because like Goa is not representing Indian culture, which I loved. It's too much of like Russian culture, international culture and like Spanish culture and all mixed together.
Portuguese.
So basically like I don't feel like it's real India. I mean like too many Russians there. Like personally for me, I don't like to meet some kind of Russian abroad. I mean because like some Russians behave very rudely when they go abroad. They don't know language and then they like behave like very like... So I don't like this kind of Russian, so normally, like, not normally, but sometimes I prefer to pretend I'm not Russian and I don't understand what they're talking about, so, yeah, so especially Arambol.
Arambol is very famous for Russians,
So, and, like, a lot of business there is owned by Russians.
So I'm so sorry, I didn't even ask your name.
Olga. Yeah.
Olga, okay. Yeah, I mean, it's so like amazing for you, I mean, to come so far from your country and then start having a life here. It's so different.
It's nice. I like it.
So how is Udesh so far?
He's good.
He's good? Just good?
Perfect.
That's what I wanted to hear. Perfect. Yeah. And Olga, it's such a pleasure meeting you. Yeah, and hopefully you will be enjoying rest of your time in India and enjoying the Indian culture. It's so I feel so proud when I see somebody who is following our tradition. I feel so nice, so great. Yeah.
I hope rest of my time in India will be very low.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, you're still young. You're going to live maybe another 50, 60 years.
Yeah.
Okay, it's a pleasure meeting you. And then I'm going to drink my... What is this? Lemon. Okay.